So now, after having some nice features, I can return to refactoring the codes here in the JDBC connector. Of course, it's a good candidate, this part here, because ensuring that an object will be of a proper type according to dust storage is of course a generic thing. As far as I remember, dust utils at converter. What's that? So attribute converter has a static thing. And so instead of fix this should come here. Again, you never did it, code. That's it. And you go back here because this is something I need. So let's just utils at converter. On a new type, this is the ColumnInfo role type and value. I am able to set the value here. Another thing is that I started to delete some code. This part here is replaced by this PF data. But I guess I can do with multiple elements. But first, let's check if I have not break. I haven't broken anything. See, load. What was the name? This was DB. Wow, that was fast. Previously, I just checked that mute functionality is going to be big. How fast are you now? It's done. Sorry. Okay. Maybe some okay, just I just want to have oh yeah, there's some unhealthy connection between these units, so I should not commit. But it seems that load was pretty fast. Try it again. Now I want to see the console. When I load this SockeDB big, it just happened immediately. So the problem was really the muting of the refresh lines code. I'm pretty happy about that. So now I can just regain some of the usability of the system. And for example, for testing, I should just load all the addresses, for example. So set a process from I want to select all the addresses. How fast are you? Bing. Not that bad. Sorry. Is there any connected here? No. Just show me. It's slow. It's still slow. Few thousand entities. have cities. Now they do that. I select these entities and I set it clean. Yes. Bing. So now delete all the entities from my system, but of course I don't want to play with this. Alright, so let's find some other elements that can be replaced by a populated factory. How about factory type infos? Type infos work the same way. The column info in the table info, I have this thing. And it should come out and replace PF type info. This should be similar. So when I start populating the type info, this is where I should create the PF type info. The set unit should also be fine because my unit is added, so that's nice. The only thing is that at this point the type info is the self is on the left and connect to data types. And the type that I want it to create projects and the studio's out resolve. I don't know if it works, but you'll see. JDBC link connector data type, and this JDBC data type. And so this can be commented out and that is PF type info get type name. Now, when I load the system, the type info factory should be populated. So during this, as the constructor runs, I should have many items in this type info. So let's say let's load socket.db. Yeah, I need to init my connector. And see how it goes. So in the PF type info, content is loaded properly. Let it go. To ensure if it works fine, I should just run the select, of course. Select the process. Yeah, I'm selecting stuff. Let's see the response. Nice. All right. And of course I can remove this part of the code, getting down to 420 lines, but of course we have other things. Ref processor, just looking for the reference processors here. All these attribute loading is Well, by the way, this could be a utility function. But not now. I just let it go. Because there's no real reason behind it. Says the LinkDef parent. Well. We have this columns list, but actually it would be nicer to have separate containers for attributes and references, both containing attributes. That would be, it is already here. Just populated factory, but not with entity, just populated factory. The value type is column info. PF at column info is undefined, yes, because I need to provide these ones. The center is okay. It shouldn't be initialized here, but as I am here, that's pf refs, and in the init data. Which I have here, I need that column info. Generic links is something these are ones that I have to grab etable, but not the connected owner, but AttDef parent. False any table. Constructor. He has the same for the same reason as this one, so I just want to create another one where type left center, and this opt resolve is there, so I can use the enum case. To create it. Very nice. And now this is when I create it for an attribute. ID and other, and when I create it, it's in the create function. Of this, the column name for creation never mind. Here, let's work with the PF press, which is LinkDef parent, and everything else is the same. Let's see. See if it works fine. To achieve this, I will again load my database, send the init here and see what is the content of PF refs and PF odds. Category ID, film ID, last update. These are the IDs and PF refs, content none. Very good. Let's see if I find someone creating refs and go And at this point, my table is the store, and in the PF refs, I have address ID and manager stuff ID, while the attributes are last update and store ID. Perfect. So that looks like a successful refactor. And at this point, I just added the information. What I need to do now is to eliminate the existing support for columns, which means I remove columns from here. Naturally, I remove these ref processors. Register column name. That's interesting. This is a problem. This is a problem because at this point I should know okay, if the FK info contains something about this, that's good. Ref means FK info get contains key call name. The call info should be is ref. If it's a reference, then the pf refs get never delete code. Set pf ads get call name result set. That's how it is. And as we go come here, okay, let's give it a function. So so now I can ask this information call name, good, then Boolean is ref. The column info is but the old function should go back there, so the table info not only does this. Info, call name, return is ref, call name, pf, refs, peak, call name, that's it. And so to get call info, call name. This part can also be fixed by his ref, then it's the same thing. Can a foreign key be part of the primary key? Yes. Unfortunately, yes. So I'm not properly prepared for this story. Now let's think that it's enough. So right now I removed the columns and replaced it with see if it still runs. All right, then I can also remove these parts here. But I should also make a new test where I recreate the types during the init. So I have to remove all the imported types from the unit. Let's see. I have the sucker database. I have store, address, store, everything. So these all these things should be removed. See if I can commit. Oh, and I wanted to add the connected type to the message. I don't know if it works or not, but at least I try. And just make sure and commit. Maybe it worked. Let's see. Is the process worked? See if I have entities here. I only have 20 entities in the database. That's very good. In the unit. So let's init and see what happens. Something happened because it seems to have populated. Okay, and let's see, for example, store type. I have the LinkDef. And I have the AttDef. Very nice. So let's see that if I select my favorite stores. It works exactly the same way. Nice. Then it seems that I was able to remove those codes. So what can I, what else can I remove? The table info factory. This is yet another interesting point here. Yes, no, I will not touch that. there will be another run here, because right now there's a funny code duplication here with the populated factory column info and the attributes and references, which leads to this strange construction, but also there is some conditional separation of data in the column info. So actually, proper refactor means that I will have a base class column info and derived classes for ref columns and attribute columns, and the actual data loading, this part where I just split, will go up to the proper derived objects. So yeah, but so far I think I'm quite fine. So I started GDB's connection on Monday, and it's Thursday today, and I have these kind of refactor problems. Okay, so thank you for watching.